Today we are going to learn about pedigree analysis. Now, what is pedigree analysis? Pedigree analysis is a very important tool in human genetics, because in human genetics we can have the controlled process, because in human genetics we, like Mendel did with the pea plant, we cannot have with human generations. So we cannot see generation after generation what is coming and how this trait is traveling from one generation to another generation. So for human genetics, we have pedigree analysis. Now, what is pedigree? Because controlled processes are not possible in case of human beings. So study of the family history about inheritance of a particular trait provides an alternative. So we study about the family, we study about the family history by making a family tree, and we see that the previous generation was having this trait or not, before that the trait was there or not, and after that the in progeny the trait is there or not. So in that, this is called the pedigree analysis, and this is a tool to find out the transfer of that trait in the family. In human genetics, pedigree study provides a strong tool which is utilized to trace the inheritance of the specific trait, abnormality or disease. Suppose there is a genetic disorder in the family. So how will we find out what are the probabilities in the progeny, or whether there is any chance of the child having that disorder or not? So all these things can be provided, this information can be provided by using this pedigree analysis. So pedigree is a genetic representation of a family tree diagram. In this, we make a family tree diagram, and the inheritance of a trait or disease through several generations. So we see generations after generations how that trait is traveling in the family. Now, at a pedigree shows the relationship between family members, and it indicates which individual expresses or silently carry the trait in question. Suppose we are studying about one particular trait or one particular disease. So the pedigree will show that whether the member is having that disease, or whether the member is carrier of that disease, or whether the member is not having the disease. So all these things can be studied, can be shown by a pedigree analysis. Now, what are the important standard symbols? Now, this pedigree analysis can be done by using standard symbols, which are uniformly accepted all over the world, and everywhere these symbols are used in whenever the pedigree analysis is done in human genetics. Now, what are these symbols? For male, a square is used. A square is used to denote a male. Circle is used to denote a female. And when suppose we want to say that this male is affected, or this male is having that disease, so we will shade the square. So this is affected individual. And if we are shading the circle, that means the female is affected. Now, if we want to show the mating between this male and female, we have to put a horizontal line. A horizontal line between the male and female shows the mating or reproduction or marriage. Now, offsprings, if we want to show the offspring, then these are the generations. First generation, second generation. Now, generations are written in Roman numbers. And offsprings are, this is male and female. Now, this horizontal line is showing the mating between these two, and this vertical line is showing the offsprings, their children, their progeny. And this progeny is from left to right. We number them from left to right. So this is, they have these parents, they first have a daughter and then they have a son. First is daughter and then the son. So this is from left to right progeny. And these are generations are written in Roman. So this is first generation, this is second generation, like that. Now, if the children are twins, so for identical twins, we will put this arrow, and then both the children will be connected by a horizontal line. This shows identical twins or monozygotic twins. And if they are non-identical, they are made from two different zygotes, then we will not put a horizontal line between them, and they will be just connected by this arrow, and male, the girl and the boy. So these are certain. Another symbols are also there. See this. This is male. Circle is female. If the sex is unspecified, transgender is there, then we put this diamond shaped structure. For affected individuals, suppose the individual is having that disease, affected, the trait which is in question, if they are having that trait, then we will put this shade. So shaded square means affected male, shaded circle means affected female. And this shows the mating between two, male and female. Now, mating between relatives, that is consanguineous mating, is shown by two horizontal lines. Two horizontal lines means the marriages between the relatives. Suppose mama's son, cha-cha's son, like that, the marriages are happening in some communities. So if the marriage is with the close relative, then this is shown with two lines, two horizontal lines. So this shows the mating between relatives. And these are the parents. After parents, if you want to show the progeny, then you have to draw a vertical line. And after vertical line, you have to show the birth. Now this has to be counted from left to right. So first the daughter and then the son. Left to right, we always count them from left to right. And what is this showing? This is showing that the parents are not affected, but their son is affected, because the parents are not shaded, but the son is shaded. So both these parents are not affected, but this son is affected. And this shows five unaffected offspring. Five offsprings are there, but they all are unaffected. So now these pedigree charts help in finding out the genetic disorder which is going on in that family. So it helps the doctor to decide that how this trait is being traveling in the family. Now this representative pedigree charts are there, pedigree analysis are there, and there are four modes of these. Now how these are the clues I have given to crack a pedigree. Suppose you have to do a pedigree analysis. So how, what are the clues to do it? Now there are four modes, four things can happen. One is the trait is autosomal dominant. That means the trait is on an autosomal chromosome, because we are having autosomal chromosomes and sex chromosomes. So if the trait is on the autosomal chromosome and the trait is dominant, then how to find out in pedigree? So what are the clues for this? Here you will see that in pedigree analysis, when you are doing the pedigree analysis, these traits, they do not skip generations. That means in every generation you will find this trait. This is one clue. Second clue is that if both parents are affected, then the children can be non-affected. The children can be unaffected even if the both parents are affected. Now, how this happens? Because this is a dominant trait. Now, suppose this is capital A. So, parents are capital A, small a. Capital A, small a. So, both parents are affected because this is dominant, and the dominant will express itself. So, both are showing that trait. Suppose it is one disease. So, both will have that disease, but their children can be small a, small a. And if their children are having homozygous recessive genotype, then they will not show this trait. So another clue for finding out autosomal dominant trait is that both parents can be affected, but their children cannot be affected. 10. These are the chances, not 100%. Okay. Now, second mode is autosomal recessive trait. The trait is on the autosomal chromosome, and the trait is recessive. So, if it is a recessive trait, they skip generations. You will find that trait or that disease in first generation. Then maybe in second and third generation, the disease has not come. And that disease is again expressing in the fourth generation. So they skip generations, the autosomal recessive trait. And unaffected parents can have affected children. Now here it is the opposite. The unaffected parents are not affected. These two are not affected because it is recessive trait. But these two are having dominant allele, so the dominant will express. So these two are not having. But the children who are having homozygous recessive genotype, they will have the disease or they will show that trait. So here, unaffected parents can have affected children. Now the third mode is sex-linked diseases or sex-linked traits. The traits which are present on the X chromosome. Now here also there can be two things, X-linked dominant trait and X-linked recessive trait. If it is X-linked dominant trait, then this disease will never transfer from father to son. Why? Because for son, what is the contribution of father? If the baby boy is there, then the contribution of father is Y chromosome. So X chromosome is not the contribution of father in son. That's why this disease is and this trait is present on X. So father cannot transfer this to the son. This is always transferred from mother to son because mother has to always contribute X. And if that X is having dominant trait and this X and the son is having X and Y, so this will be expressed in son. So always transfers from mother to son. All daughters of an affected father. Now an affected father means what? The trait is there on the X chromosome of the father and father is having Y. Now daughter for daughter, the sperm is contributing X. For all baby girls, the father's contribution is X. So what would be the result? All daughters will have this X-linked dominant trait. So all daughters would be affected if the father is affected. Now see another mode which can happen is X-linked recessive trait. That means this trait is present on the X chromosome, but it is recessive trait. Now here the males are not affected. Why males are not affected? Because males are having one X and one Y. So if X is having the recessive trait, the male will not be affected. Now these diseases, they tend to transfer from mother to son and father to daughter because mother has to contribute the X. So if mother is contributing X and the son is having X and Y, so in case of baby boy, the father is contributing Y and the mother is contributing X. And if that X is having the recessive trait, the son is having that disease. And another case would be father to daughter, because father is contributing X for baby girl. So if the father is having that trait and it is recessive trait X-linked, then it may go to the daughter. Now, never transfer from father to son. Father cannot transfer it to the son because father is contributing only Y sex chromosome for the baby boy. So these are the certain clues by which you can crack the pedigree analysis. And now from your NCERT book only. Now, if we see this pedigree analysis, now, the clue, as per the clues, we have to find out that what this can be. Now, see, first generation, there is one affected, one the mother is affected. Now, from mother, the son is affected, the second generation also. Then, now, these two are having four children. first daughter, second son, third son, and fourth daughter. Now their third son is getting married to an unaffected female, and their children are not affected at all. All three of them are not affected. But when their daughter is getting married to an unaffected male, their daughter is affected. So that means this trait is shown in all generations. This is first generation, this is second generation, this is third generation. So the clue is that this is autosomal dominant trait. This is the clue that it is autosomal dominant trait. Why? Because it is shown in all generations, number one. Number two, it is not only in females or not only in males. Male and female both are affected. So this is autosomal dominant. Now see this. Now here, what is the case? The male is there, female is there, and after their mating, they are having five children. And first one is boy, second one is boy, third one is a girl, fourth one is a girl, and fifth one is a boy. Now when this third girl, when she is getting married to a boy, their first child is affected. That means they both are not affected. They both are not affected, but their child is affected. So this is the clue that it is autosomal recessive trait. So these are, this is how we can crack the pedigree analysis, and how we can crack it by these clues which I have given you. Similarly, there are X-linked recessive and X-linked dominant also. So this is all about the pedigree analysis.